when we talk about voluntary non-fit in GDR, there are few exceptions to this principle of or defense of voluntary non-fit in GDR, where under dependent cannot take this defense and cannot say that I should be relieved from the compensation. Now, what are these exceptions that are there with to this? The first one is that if a consent of the plaintiff has been obtained by fraud or under compulsion or under some mistaken impression. Now, like for example, this is a case that is there where a woman who was 40 years old and she wanted to get a surgery for her breast as she had some lumps. And therefore, the hospital people, what they took a consent form. She signed a consent form on the ground that if any mishappening happens during the surgery, then the association, medical association will not be liable for any compensation. Okay, the hospital. Then but what happened during the surgery, along with the breast lumps, it was the uterus also that was removed without any justification, without any reason being given by the doctors to the patient. Now, in this case, court held that the consent was with respect to the surgery relating to the lumps that were there in the breast and not with respect to the treatment of uterus. So they have extended the consent. The consent that has been given was only for the lumps and not for any uterus. So when we are talking about this aspect, what is it? What type of consent is it? It's a consent and a misuse of this consent that has been given by the plaintiff, right? So it is a mistaken impression. So when we are talking about fraud, it has been committed by the hospital. So in this case, what happened? Hospital was held liable to pay compensation to the plaintiff. And it was held that it was outside the scope of what of the consent that was given by the plaintiff. So if it is going beyond the ambit of the consent that is given, in that case, the defendant shall be held liable for any kind of compensation. Is it clear? So the requirement was only to treat the breast and not to touch. And there is no way your breast or your uterus is related to each other. Right, and if it required any kind of surgery, they should have informed the patient that this is something more that has can be required from the surgery. Right, this can be the repercussion. So that information, lack of information that lies from the part of hospital association, in that case, you can bring an action against such people. So any kind of consent that has been given by you under a mistaken fact, fraud, or compulsion will not entitle to free consent as exist for the defense of voluntary non-fit in GDR. And the concept of free consent, you have studied in law of contract also. So it's the same concept that the consent should not be backed by any such undue influence, coercion, fraud, or mistaken facts, okay? So this is first, that the consent should be free. It should not be backed by any such factors. Now, second is that if a consent is given and that consent results in any immoral act. So if there is any consent and consent results in immoral cause. Like, for example, in this case, what happened? The defendant, who was 16-year-old girl, she was taking lessons from her teacher. Now, teacher, what defendant did was, told her that in order to improve her voice, she need to get into a sexual intercourse with him. So she consented to this fact. So he, what has he done? He has taken the consent for an immoral act. So he in this case, defendant was held liable. And you please keep this in mind that this is what we are discussing under law of tort, where the consent is not a free consent. But in such cases, you will see this thing that you can go for other remedies. Like in the previous case, you can go for medical negligence. In this case, you can go for rape under IPC, right? So it's not that we do not have any, when we are talking about such cases, when there are they are serious in nature, then in that case, the cases are taken up under criminal law. So it's, as an example, to make you understand that when we are talking about consent, then what factors are related to this consent? Okay, so this is another case where it was held by the court that wherever the consent results to an immoral result, then that consent is not a valid consent. It's not a free consent. Third is where the consent is given under compulsion. So it says that consent which is given under circumstances, when a person does not have a freedom of choice, is not the proper consent. A person may have compelled by a situation under which he has knowingly undertaken work which, if he had free choice, he would not have taken it. So if there would have been some choice, some option, then the person would not have acted in that particular manner. So the consent is under compulsion. There is you have been compelled to act in a particular manner, right? And it is believed that such consents are generally arises out of master-servant relationship. Okay, thus a man cannot be said to be truly willing unless he is in a position to choose freely. If you are in a position to choose freely, it means you have given a free consent. Okay, and freedom of choice predicates not only full knowledge of circumstances on which exercise of choice is conditional, so that he may be able to choose wisely, but the absence of any feeling of constraint, okay, so that nothing shall interfere with the freedom of his will. So what is this? This is one of the observations which is there in the quote. I have where the quote said that the, what do you mean by free consent? Free consent means that where you have different options and it is a conditional choice that you may or may not go for it. If you want, you can go for it. If you don't want, you cannot. You have this freedom to just let it go, right? So therefore, what happens? Voluntary law of injuria will not be applicable in this case where the consent has been given under compulsion. So like, for example, if I say that the plaintiff, these are few examples that are there. Like, for example, another example I would like to give here is, like, for example, if I ask my employee to go and murder somebody. So what is it? It is under compulsion, first of all. Secondly, it is an illegal act for which I'm giving the directions, right? So this is, these are the few cases that is Smith versus Baker, where the plaintiff employed Baker to work on drill for cutting rocks, right? Now what happened? Stones were carried out with the help of crane from one place to another. While the crane was passing, one of the stone fell on the plaintiff's head, due to which severe injuries were caused, right? And now what happened? Can you hold liable plaintiff, this person who was taking care of the crane? Can you make him liable for the injury that has been caused to the another person? No. Why you cannot hold liable? Because that person who is working in the direction of some other person. Okay, so here the employer cannot take the defense of voluntary non-fit injuria, that this man was picking up the stones voluntarily and there was consent of doing this work. Another example, like for example, is like you must have seen many people cleaning the buildings. Right now, in that case, what happened? If any kind of accident happens, if that person suffers an injury by falling down from that particular building, then who shall be liable? Can in this case employer say that the person has given the consent, the knowledge was there that if he's going to go so high over the building, then there is possibility of getting injured, right? So in this case, the defense of employer will not stand good. It is the compensation, the employee will be entitled to the compensation. Okay, so what is it? It is talking about such situations where a person is doing work, but under certain circumstances, such work can be, and such work leads to where there is no option. So you must have seen that people who are doing any kind of job, or mainly for like drivers, cleaners, they are at the risk of their life also while doing all these acts. So in this case, that's why the employer's liability is there under our labor laws also. So the employer is liable to the compensation to employee if there is any injury which is caused in the course of employment and during the course of employment. So if there is any injury which is suffered during the employment, then employer will be liable. Then employer cannot take the defense of voluntary non-fit. Okay. So another case is the rescue case. Now let's say I'll get back later on at the end. Okay. rescue case is the another one. So in this, what happens now, this situation says, let's say because of my negligence, I'm the employer of a restaurant. And because of my negligence, there is a fire that broke out in the restaurant, leading to sufferings to people. Now, there is another person who is in my neighborhood. That person voluntarily comes and saves people out, helps them to come out of that restaurant, right? Now, in this case, also, the person that is me, the defendant, cannot take this plea that the person who saved others had done the act voluntarily. It's a rescue case. So in this case, also the defense of voluntary non-fit injury will not fit for employer. And this is the case, the employer will be liable to pay compensation not only to others who have suffered injury because of the negligence of one of the employee maybe, right? But it is the employer who is held liable. If you remember your strict and absolute liability, MC Mehta case is one. Case and Renault versus Fletcher is another that will do at a later stage. Okay, but here what we are understanding is the rescue case. So if I am rescuing somebody, then in that case, what happens? I cannot take up this plea that the person has done this voluntarily. Clear? So these are two cases that are there. You can go through the cases, right? So where there are rescue cases, even there, there lies the liability to pay compensation. So these are few exceptions that are there relating to the defense of voluntary non-fit injury. And kindly go through the PPT and I'll be uploading side by side the notes that are required in order to understand the